Hi, welcome to the evening salon and spa. How can I help you? You're here to get your makeup done? Okay, sounds great. Do you have an appointment? No, that's okay. We accept walk-ins happily. So why don't you get yourself settled in? And may I offer you some tea or coffee? I just made some fresh coffee in our French press. Would you like that? Yeah? Okay, great. Okay, so let me just prepare you a cup. Favorite cup. It's very pretty, huh? Yeah. It smells so nice. I love it. Okay. So, do you take any cream or sugar in your coffee? No, just as is. Okay, great. All right, now I'm gonna set this on the side table while you sit down. Don't wanna spill it everywhere, because I'll certainly do that if you give me the chance to. Okay. Okay, so why don't you tell me a little about the kind of look that you're going for, and if you have an event to go to, or you're just doing this because you just want to pamper yourself a little bit. Yeah. You have a wedding. Okay. Are you in the wedding party or are you a guest? You're a guest. All right. Why don't you tell me a little bit about your outfit? What are you wearing? Sounds beautiful. Very classic. Great choice. So how would you like your makeup to reflect your outfit? Do you want it to be very classic as well? Yeah? So would you like a smoky eye or a wing, cat eye? Like a traditional smoky eye, or would you like maybe like a plum sort of smoky? Because you have a very neutral colored dress, you could go with the color on the pop of your lid. Or depending, what about your shoes? What do your shoes look like? They're just nude. Okay, very pretty. I know. For someone like me, nude shoes are a great choice because they elongate your legs. I'm a little short. Yeah, okay. Okay, so we can play it by ear. I can present you with a few different options and you can tell me what you like and what you don't like. Okay. For every session, no matter what treatment our guests are getting done, I like to begin with a nice hand and arm massage. Is that something you'd be interested in? It's complimentary. Yeah? Oh, great. I think it does wonders just to relax you, just to get you ready for your treatment, so you can fully experience, you know, the service. Okay. Okay. So, we have a few different lotions that I can use. We have a very beautiful lavender lotion. It's made with organic lavender. And we also have an uplifting citrus and mint lotion. It's also very beautiful. And third, we have a rose lotion. It has a few different rose oils in it. It's also very lovely. What would you like? The lavender. Yeah. There's nothing more calming than lavender, in my opinion. Okay. Here. Just gonna warm it up in my hands. Okay. Should come a little closer, is that okay? Why don't you give me your hand? Okay. Yeah. I don't think we realize how often our hands are kind of sore and just overworked. I guess not until after a massage like this do you realize how badly you needed it. Right? About it. I mean, what other muscles do we use in our body as often as the muscles in our hands, right? The tendons in your wrist and your forearm also feel so nice to work them out. Get a little bit more lotion, okay? Right. Does that feel good? Yeah. May I have your left hand? Great. I see you have a tattoo. What is it? What does it symbolize, if you don't mind me asking? Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, I like that. Okay. It's between your thumb and your index finger. Pressure point. Look at that. Okay, great. All right. So, are you ready to begin? Okay. So we can start out with a primer. Actually, before we do that, I'm actually going to cleanse your skin. I know it looks very healthy, but sometimes when we're outside, there's particles from the ozone, dust and dirt in the air that can clog our pores. So I'm going to take an exfoliating wipe. These are very exfoliating. Do you have sensitive skin? No, not really. Well, I'm actually going to take some aloe and rose water after this to calm your skin down. If this does leave behind some redness. But it's a really deep clean. Sounds great. Okay. Okay. first, I'm going to take the soft side. Just wipe off any makeup you might have on your face. Okay. Down your nose. Okay. Around your hairline. Yeah. Your jaw. Okay, and the other side. Just under your brow. Around your hairline. Your neck too, okay? Okay, great. Now I'm going to use the buffing side. You can see that. Perforation sort of on the pad. Just gonna work in small circles. Feels nice? Yeah. Okay. The other side. Okay. Okay. This also clears away any blackheads that might be your T-zone. It's usually where they show up, huh? Yeah, okay. Pay special attention to that area, okay? That's what I'm going to do. Alright. Beautiful, you're very fresh-faced and ready for your makeup. I'm gonna put a little aloe and rose water here. It's this great Mario Badescu. Okay. Are you allergic to anything? No. Perfect. Okay, ready? Smells nice, huh? Okay, I'm just gonna pat that in. Okay, perfect. All right, now all that dries. Show you, I have a couple different primers. I'm actually gonna use this primer because I think this is the best and it holds up the longest. And since you know you might be dancing at the wedding, hopefully this would be the best for you. It's Guerlain L'Or. Means gold if you don't speak French. Those little flecks of gold in there. Great for your skin. Don't ask me why. That's just what they say. Okay, I'm just gonna squeeze them out here. Motions. It's also very firming. Here we go. Tap that a little more. Tap, tap, tap. Great. Tap, tap, tap. Beautiful. You're very pretty. Alright, so foundation. This is something that you can choose. As far as coverage, what do you like? Do you like more sheer or medium or full coverage? Don't worry, your foundation's not gonna budge with that primer on. Okay. You wanna go with the medium coverage? Okay. So I'm just gonna match you. A few different foundations here. Turn your face to the side. No, we're gonna go with something cooler, okay? Excuse me. All right, let's try this shade. Gonna go with a Bare Minerals foundation. It's a gel cream. I like gel foundation because it doesn't clog your pores. And this is actually SPF 30. It's the wedding outside. The ceremony is perfect. Okay. Some on our beauty blender here. Excuse me, I'm sorry. A little more. So tell me, are you friends with the bride or the groom? The bride. Oh, she's actually your cousin. Okay. Has she known her future spouse for long? They're high school sweethearts. That's sweet. Okay, now we're going to do some contouring. Is that okay? May as well go all out. Since you have a very cool tone, cool tones to your skin, I'm going to use this contour pan. It might look very dark. Don't worry. It's really sharp. It's very cool though. Excuse me, I thought I was gonna sneeze. Okay. here, carve out your cheekbones. Think a little bit more. We're gonna put some on your temple a little bit. Your other side. A beautiful heart-shaped face. Very beautiful. Okay. So now we can go on. Your eyes. Okay. So what we can do is I think you could have a different opinion if you'd like. Of course. We can just want to make you happy. But we can take a very black, very, very black eyeshadow. And do a smoky eye. And this is a very creamy matte color that just blends beautifully. And then we can take a gel, like a glossy eyeliner, and do a nice wing. Does that sound okay? Yeah. Great. So does matte sound okay? Or we can also do a very editorial sort of glossy eyelid, but in black. That sounds fun, right? A black glossy. So it's gonna be a black glossy smoky eye. It'll be great. And if you don't like it, we can do it again. Yeah. You can stay here until you're happy. Alright. Okay, so we primed your eyelid with the Guerlain. Now we're gonna take the black eyeshadow. Tap off the excess. Close your eyelid. Okay, good job. Okay, just gonna start in the outer corner and work our way to the inner corner, pulling the color to the outer eye as I go. Little more, we're gonna deepen the outer corner. Okay. Alright. Okay, beautiful. Now your other eye. We're gonna take my fluffy blending brush and we're just gonna blend it so it looks very cozy, cohesive, no sharp lines. Okay, you ready? Close your eye. Beautiful. Okay, let me take a look at your other eye. Blend. Alright, so now I'm going to do the wing before we put the gloss on top. I'm gonna do the wing with this brush. It's an eyeliner brush, but I think it's perfect. Really get that corner right in there. Okay, so we're gonna dip it. This brush really creates the perfect wing. Okay, perfect. Perfect. I'm gonna wash this off before it dries. It's very pigmented. Looks great. You trust me. So now we're going to take the very glossy, it's kind of like a glossy top coat for your eyelid. It's called the Eye Vinyl by Milk. I think all the products are really cool. Okay. Alright, so close your eye. I'm going to concentrate the most, because this does have pigment as well. Gonna concentrate the most on your outer corner and just swoop it to get the rest of your lid, okay? So it creates a very sultry look. Yeah, alright, ready? Other eye. Alright. Swoop. Okay. It's very eye-catching. You look great. Okay. Now I'm going to do a little peachy blush. Also will work as a highlighter because I'm going to put it on your cheekbones near your temples because you do have a heart-shaped face. So I think that putting your blush on the tops of your cheeks near your temples would be great for your face shape. Now you can choose from a few different colors that I think will be suitable for your skin tone. First we have this lovely La Croix & Co. blush. It's a cream blush in Preacher's Daughter. Okay. It's very pretty. I'm not sure if you can see that. I also have a peachy gold baked blush there. It's also very pretty. Or if you really wanted something bright, it's totally up to you. I don't really recommend it because your eyes are so alluring. I think it would take away from the effect, but I also have a very bright pink in the shade I'm Shocked. You want to go with the cream? Very suitable. Okay. Get that back out. All right. I'm gonna take my brush. It is a cream, but it blends very, very well. Powder brush. Right there on the cheekbone. It has a little shimmer in it, so it acts also as a highlighter. Okay. Beautiful. Okay. Let's talk about your lips. I think we should go with a very subtle pink, maybe a matte to balance your eyes because your lids are very glossy. Yeah, it's usually the inverse. Your lips are usually shiny and sparkly, and your most eyeshadows are very matte, or I mean, they could be shimmery too, but most of the time it's a matte shimmer. So I like to begin by lining your lips. I'll do that in this lip pencil by Urban Decay. And I might have to come very close. Color in the corners to give you more perceived volume in your lip. It's very subtle because it's a very light pink. Alright. Beautiful. Different pinks. You also have like a taupe that might work too. Okay, first we have a lip crayon by NARS. Okay, it's in the shade Sex Machine. We also have a very soft matte liquid lip. Smells like frosting. It's really pretty. This is actually what I have on my lips. It's called To Louise. It's sort of a brown taupe. Very kind of nudie. We also have a liquid suede. The shade is Tea and Cookies. Yeah. Okay. We can go with this one. Okay, so just pout your lips like that. Okay. It's okay. You're allowed to have your phone on. Okay. And last but not least, your mascara. This is my favorite mascara. It's by Milk, just like the eye bottle. It's called the Ubami Mascara, and this has crushed sapphire in it, so it really makes your eyes sparkle. Yeah. It's a very unique applicator. Okay. So when I tell you, I want you to blink. Applicator makes your lashes very full. Okay, ready? Blink. 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 Okay. So what I like to do is go over it with a second coat to lengthen your lashes. But this time, I'm going to use a different one. This one's gonna lengthen and curl. The Milk did a good job at volumizing. Okay. Blink. 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 Very beautiful. Okay. So, your makeup looks absolutely stunning. You're going to light up the room. And as a finishing touch, to keep everyone on your mind long after you've left the room, I'm going to give a little spray of perfume. And I have a little kit here. It's the Juliet Has a Gun perfume line. We have an array of scents here. And I'm going to let you... They are very long lasting, but you may want to freshen up your scent after you've spent some time at the wedding. So I'm going to give you a tube of the scent of your choosing. I'm going to explain what we have. Okay. So, the first perfume is called, it's the one at the top. It's called Not a Perfume. It is a very minimalist, elegant, pure scent. It's subtle, a subtle woody note with a clean and modern trail. It is a mono ingredient. Just has one ingredient. And it's without allergens and ideal to blend with other perfumes. And that scent is called Cetalox. And what Cetalox is the synthetic form of ambergris. Have you heard of ambergris? Ambergris is the ingredient in a lot vintage perfumes. I know King Louis was a big fan of using ambergris. It's a very distinctive scent, very unique. It's, however, ambergris in its organic form is illegal in the United States and many other countries because it is from the bodily secretions of a sperm whale. Yeah. So that's why perfumer has created the synthetic version of ambergris. Okay, and that's called Cetalox, which is the only ingredient in this perfume. The next perfume is called and it's a mouthwatering name that suggests delicatessen and, I'm sorry, that's, a delicatessen is a, like cheeses and meats, right? But it's not the word here. Delectation and excites all senses. A gourmand yet elegant composition. A zero-calorie treat to be consumed without moderation. And the main ingredients in this are neroli, raspberry, tuberose, and iris butter. Next perfume is called Anyway, and this is Anyway is a floral, citrus, musky, nonchalant and easy to wear. It embodies a certain optimism, ready to unite with the feminine as much as the masculine. And the main ingredients in this are green lime, hedion, and musk. So the next perfume is called Mad Madame. And Mad Madame has a green and metallic chapire. Mad Madame has the knack of getting herself talked about, and she likes it. So the ingredients in Mad Madame are rose oxide, black currant, bud absolute, and ambroxan. And we have four more scents for you to choose from. The next is called Gentlewoman. A lot of these scents, actually all of these scents, are can be used for anyone, really. They're not just feminine perfumes. So, Gentlewoman is a masculine cologne dedicated to women or men. The note revolves around the neroli essence, the orange blossom absolute, and the delicious almond essence. The main ingredients are neroli, almond, and musk. Next, we have Miss Charming. And Miss Charming is a musky floral, yet fruity fragrance. The portrait of a young, natural, and innocent woman, but nonetheless surprising. If she's a rose, don't forget, she also has spines. The main ingredients in this are rose, musk, and wild fruits. Next we have Lady Vengeance. And Lady Vengeance is a perfume with a rich and sophisticated trail. The expression of undeniable femininity, confident and divinely sensual. This has Bulgarian rose, patchouli, and vanilla. And last, we have another ode. Just the opposite. This fragrance suggests an immersion to the Oriental world version 2.0. The ingredients are bergamot, oud wood, cashmeron, raspberry, and musk. Do any of these sound nice to you? They do. Which? Want to try the first one? Or Mad Madame. Here, you can smell both. Okay. This is the first one, which is the made with only one note. You like that? And we also have Mad Madame. That is here. Okay. one is, Madame has the knack of getting herself talked about, and she likes it. Yeah. Okay. What do you think? You like the Madame? Okay. So it's yours. I'm just gonna spray a little behind your ear, near your neck. Later, if you'd like, your clutch. Okay. So it was so lovely to meet you, and I had a great time doing your makeup. I hope you have a great time at the wedding. Okay. All right, take care.